Hi students, how are you all?
Right.
In the last session, we have seen studied about Sushruta, an ancient plastic surgeon. You know, in the midnight, during the late hours of midnight, a stranger comes, knocks his door. He says that he needs his help, and right, Sushruta opens his door, right. And he sees this man kneeling down on the knees, and he sees his nose has been disfigured or damaged, and all over his face there was blood, right? We are in the third session. And in this session we are going to see what has happened in the rest of the story. And this doctor Sushruta instructs him to come back after few weeks, right? And he will give him what to do and what not to do, what to eat and what not to eat, the medicines, medicines list, and also the herbs that he needs to take till the nose gets cured, right? In page number 38, we'll see the remaining of the story. In this manner, Sushruta mended a nose some 26 centuries ago. This incident, the mending of nose or making the nose again, repairing or operating the nose after it has been damaged, this has been done some 26 centuries ago. You and I have been not born during that time, not in your parents or anyone. This incident has happened some centuries ago. 26 centuries ago, and what he did is not greatly different from a plastic surgeon. He did exactly like how nowadays plastic surgeon, the doctors who are making plastic surgeries, is exactly the same. In fact, Sushruta is today recognized as the father of plastic surgery all over the world because of this incident, what Sushruta has done 26 centuries before. From this practice or from his surgery, the others also learned how to make plastic surgery, and he is called as the father of the plastic surgeries, right? That's why we got the name Sushruta, an ancient plastic surgeon, right? His treatise, Sushruta Samhita, has considerable medical knowledge of relevance even today. His book, it indicates that India was far ahead of the rest of the world in medical knowledge. It might be his book that he has written. In that book, he says that before the medicine or the operations have been started in the rest of the world, Indians had more knowledge in the field of medicine, right? Both born in 6th century, this man is born in 6th century BC. Sushruta was descendant of Vedic sage Vishwamitra. He is a follower of sage Vishwamitra. He learned surgery and medicine at the feet of Divodasa Danavantari. Divodasa Danavantari in his hermitage at Varanasi. Later he became an authority in not only surgery but also in other branches of medicine, right? He was a follower or descendant of Vedic sage Vishwamitra, and he learned surgery or medicine from a person called Divodasa Danavantari in his hermitage, right? That is located in a place called Varanasi. Later he became an authority not only became authority in surgery but also in other branches of medicine, right? He was the first physician to advocate what is known today as cesarean operation. He was also an expert in removing urinary stone. Nowadays, right, cesarean, you might not know what is this, right? This is done usually during childbirth. The child is removed by following this technique, cesarean, right? They cut open the stomach and by giving anesthesia, the child is taken out. This process is called cesarean, and he is the one who invented this process, and also he is an expert in removing the urinary stones, that means the kidney stones, right? His suggestion to give wine to patient about to be operated upon makes him also father of anesthesia. You know, when this stranger came, he gave a mug of wine so that this wine makes this person unconscious. And from this, from his technique, people also learned the usage of anesthesia, and he is called as father of anesthesia. In his treatise or in his book, Sushruta lists 101 types of instruments. His Samadasa Yantras are the first forms of the modern surgeons, spring forceps and dissection and dressing forceps. In fact, his system of naming surgical tools after the animals or birds they resemble in shape. For example, crocodile forceps, hawk's bill forceps is adopted even today. See, he named his instruments basing on the shapes or the shapes of the birds, right? And these namings of instruments that is even followed today. You can see the pictures here in your textbook, right? Sushruta was also known as excellent teacher. He told his pupils that one could become a good physician only if one knew both theory and practice. He told his students or his followers that one can become a good physician or a doctor only when he knows about the knowledge of medicine and also how the knowledge as how to do the practical or how to do the surgeries, right? He advised his people to use carcasses and models for practice before surgery. You know, he advised his students or his followers before operating directly on the patient. He told him that they should take a practical class on the models so that they will have clear understanding when they are practicing with the models, right? Models for practice before surgery, so that while doing the surgery on any human being, they will not do any kind of mistake, right? Hope you all have understood this story about Sushruta, who was an ancient scientist and who was the inventor of this plastic surgery, and also he is the one who started the usage of anesthesia, and he is a great expert in removing the urinary stones, and he wrote many books, and from this lesson we can understand what he tells us, that if you want to be great physician or a doctor, we need to learn about medicine, and we also need to have the knowledge of how to do surgeries. Then only we can become good doctors or good surgeons, right? And this story is extracted from Scientists of India, which is published by Children's Book Trust, New Delhi, right? And in page number 39, you have five questions. And the answers you will find in your study material, and you have to write all these five question answers in your classwork, right? All of you must write all these five question answers in your classwork without fail, right? And under that you have some box, do you know? We'll see what this is. It takes 20 seconds for a red blood cell to circle the whole body. One red blood cell take 20 seconds to travel circle around the body, starting from heart to again circling from feet and coming back. It takes only 20 seconds for each red blood cell. Now RBC are called as red blood cells, right? Second, it has been proven that people can lessen reactions to allergies by laughing. You know, if you have any kind of allergy, you can overcome that by laughing or smiling, right? 6-year-old laugh on an average of 300 times, but adults laugh only 15 to 100 times per a day. These are like fun facts. Say, 6-year-old people, maybe boy and girl, they will laugh on an average 300 times in a day, in a 24-hour day, right? And 6-year-old boy or girl will laugh or smile for 300 times, whereas the elders or the adults can only laugh for 15 to 100 times in a day. Next, water freezes at 32 degree Fahrenheit and boils at 212 degree Fahrenheit. There are 180 degrees between freezing and boiling because there are 180 degrees between north and south, right? The difference between boiling point and freezing point is 180 degrees. It says here it is because the difference between North Pole and South Pole is 180 degrees, right? Next, share this joke. Some joke is given here. I'll read. The surgeon told his patient who woke up after having been operated. You know, the doctor is telling to the patient when he woke up after this operation has been done, I'm afraid we are going to have to operate you again. He said, once they have already performed surgery on this man, he woke up. When he woke up, this doctor is telling to the patient that he needs to undergo a surgery again. Because you see, I forgot my rubber gloves inside you. He said, he has forgotten the surgical gloves or the rubber gloves inside his body. Well, if it is just because of them, I'd rather pay for them if you just leave me alone. He's saying, if it is that, I'll just pay you how much it costs for your gloves. This patient is saying to the doctor, if gloves are left in my body, I will pay how much money it costs for you, but I will not undergo any kind of operation, he's telling. And he's saying, just leave me alone. Again, next we have, do you know, the average human body contains enough sulfur to kill all fleas on an average a dog. The sulfur, right? Sulfuric acid that is in our body is enough to kill a dog. That much powerful our body is, right? And that is released during digestion process. To digest our food, some acids or some enzymes, some chemicals are released into our stomach. And one of the chemical is sulfur. And that sulfur is capable of killing a dog. Carbon that we have inside our body, it can make 900 pencils, and the potassium that we have in our body to fire a toy cannon, right? The fat that we have in our body can make 7 bars of soap. Phosphorus that we have in our body to make 2200 match heads, you know, matchsticks which we use to light candles or gas stoves. Right, by using the phosphorus in our body, they can make 2200 match heads that we have on the top of the matchstick, and enough water to fill a 10-gallon tank, a very big tank. That much water we have in our body. Your fingernails grow 4 times as fast as your toenails. You know, toes means the nails that you have on your feet, right? Fingernails will go 4 times faster than the nails which you have on your feet. Babies are born with 300 bones and adults have 206. You know, when babies are born, it seems that they have 306, but as they become into adults, these bones are condensed, or they will be only 206 when they become into adults, right? The smallest bone in your body is in your ears, right? In your ears, there are very small bones called malleus, tapis, incus. 3 types of bones are there. malus epicincus. In that, one is the very smallest bone which is present in our ears. Fifth one, a sneeze blows air out of your nose at 100 miles per hour. 100 miles per hour when we sneeze, when we cough, right? The air will come at the speed of 100 miles per hour. That means very speed, right? Children have more taste buds than adults. You know, small children will have more taste buds are located on your tongue, right? By using these taste buds only, you can taste anything. By tasting so and so, you can tell what it is, right? It seems that children will have more taste buds than the older people or the adults. Bones are 4 times stronger than concrete. You know, concrete is used for making slabs, right? If you have seen that the machine will be going round and round, they will add sand, cement, these metal stones, right? They keep it on the, they make it as a roof, right? If you hit the roof, it will be very strong, that concrete. But it says here, our bones are more stronger than the concrete. Human body has approximately 37,000 miles of capillaries. You know, blood inside your body, there are blood capillaries where the blood flows inside the tubes. These tubes extend, their extension is 37,000 miles, right? If they are arranged in a straight way, they will come exactly 37,000 miles, right? A square of human skin has 32 million bacteria on it. A square of human skin has 32 million bacteria on it. On our skin, a square of skin, we have 32 million of bacteria on our skin, right? Last one. The liver is the body's chemical factory. From the liver, lot of chemicals get released. So it says it is called as a chemical factory of our body. It has over 500 functions. Liver can perform almost 500 functions in our body, right? In all this unit, we are learning about science. First, we have learned about C.V. Raman, the pride of India, how he has the invention that he has made, the Nobel Prize that he has got. And in the poem, we have understood this girl, how she is telling how the science has been developed. And in this story also, Sushruta, an ancient plastic surgeon, we understood that he is also a doctor or a physician. And all these lessons that we have learned, they deal with the science, that may be biological science or physical science, right? Science is a part of our everyday life, right? Without science, life would be very difficult. Yes or no, right? And, you know, I have wrote some words on the board. Awakened, frantic, tragedy, anguished, befallen, stranger, disfigured, creeper, cautiously, transplanted, molding, mended, surgeon, physician, anesthesia. All these words you have to write each one 5-5 times in your homework notes. And also, I have told you to write all the question and answers which are given in page number 39 in your class notes, looking into your study materials, right? All of you, you must have study material, workbook and textbook, class running notes or classwork. And also homework. All these books you must have. Understood, all of you? And it is also good that you find out the meanings of these words from the dictionary. It is also good for you to learn the meanings of these words from the dictionary, so that it will be easy for you to understand the meanings of these words which are given from your lesson. Understood, all of you? So, hope you will do all the work that is given in this session. You have to write question answers, right? You have to write all the hard words each one 5-5 times. and you need to find the meanings of these words from the dictionary, right? This is all for this session, and we will meet for the next session. Till then, have a nice time.